By the grace of God, this is online drama ministration. And today we are going to do episode 10. Praise the Lord. The Lord has been so good from episode 1, and today we are going to present episode 10. And by the grace of God, my wife and I will be ministering to you. Yes, you in particular. By the grace of God, wonderful program, drama ministration the Lord has laid upon our heart. And we know the Lord is going to minister to you in the name of Jesus. We thank you for all your likes, for all the comments and the feedback. And we believe God that this drama we want to present to you, we want to minister to you today, the Lord is going to use you. We just want to minister to you in the name of Jesus. And I pray that the purpose of God for all this online drama ministration will be fulfilled in our lives in the name of Jesus. Please, you can share this video, and I pray the Lord is going to minister to us in the name of Jesus. Watch and be blessed. Thank you.
I pray God will deliver you in the name of Jesus. Lord God Almighty, have mercy upon you, Mr. Blessing. In the name of Jesus.
Pastor, I want to vomit.
Oh Lord, I pray. Have mercy upon you, Mr. Blessing, oh Lord. In the name of
Pastor, help me.
Sister Blessing.
Pastor, I need your help.
Rest, Sister Joy.
She's not at home.
Your husband, she's not at home. You're the one at home.
Pastor, please come. Pastor.
Lord, what should I do now?
Pastor.
Lord, what should I do now? Sister Blessing, are you alright now?
I'm alright.
Are you alright?
I'm not alright, Pastor. I'm not alright, John. mercy. Pastor, come.
Lord, don't you like me now?
Yeah. Pastor, yes, Pastor, thank you. Thank you, Pastor.
Lord Jesus, what have I got myself into now? Ha, Lord, ha, my God, me, ah, Lord, I'm sorry, Lord, oh, my God, ah, sister blessed me, my reputation. My relationship with God, ah Lord.
Pastor, Pastor.
Sister, leave me alone.
Pastor, Pastor.
Leave me alone. Pastor, Sister Blessing. You told me to come and pray for you, and this is what you landed me to.
Pastor.
Leave me alone, Sister Blessing.
Pastor.
My God.
Anyway, Pastor. Anyway.
You led me to sin.
Pastor, that's not sin. We enjoyed ourselves.
This enjoyment.
Mission accomplished.
Instead of what you repent of our sin, you are telling me you enjoyed ourselves.
Pastor.
Leave me alone.
Why are you afraid?
Lord.
Why are you afraid, Pastor? Eh?
Leave me alone.
Anyway, so when next am I seeing you?
Sister, bless you. Be careful. Oh, Lord, that mercy, Lord. Oh.
Pastor, Pastor.
God is going to punish you for what you led me to this day.
What did I
do? God is going to punish you.
There is no punishment here, Pastor. Lord. We just enjoyed ourselves. We just enjoyed ourselves.
I think God will punish you.
Pastor, what is the punishment there now? Yeah, okay. Let me go and check what I put in there. Good, 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 good. Very good. Very, very good. Thank God that I put the other camera there. Yes. Okay. Mission accomplished. Pastor, Pastor. Pastor, Pastor. So, let's see what Pastor is going to do about this one now. Pastor, Pastor. He's calling me. I will not pick his call. Pastor, Pastor.
What did you just send to me?
Pastor, what does it look like?
How did you get this video? How did you record it?
Pastor.
And Sister Blessing, what have you led me to?
Pastor, calm down. I have neighbors here. Don't shout, eh? Don't shout, Pastor. I have neighbors here. Okay? You must not shout.
My reputation just checks, Sister Blessing. Look. Why did you record this at our act? Well, oh my God.
I just had a camera inside and I connected it to my phone here. You know, it's good to keep beautiful memories like this, you know?
Sister Blessing, what are you up to? You led me to this. You recorded this video. What are you up to? What are you up to? Oh
my what God. Am I up to? Pastor? Nothing much. Well, if you don't want Mommy Pastor to see this, you see, look at everything. I just connected it together. If you don't want your wife, Mommy Pastor, to see this, let's start with 3,000 euros.
What?
Yeah, 3,000
euros. 3,000
euros? Something like
that. Where do you want me to get it?
3,000 euros. 3,000 euros.
Sister Blessing, what? You know I'm not going up to that money. How do you want me to get the 3,000
euros? Pastor, what do you mean? We have
please,
such...
Please, Sister Blessing, hey, don't...
Please, will you keep quiet and allow me to talk? What do you mean you are not earning up to that small amount?
Sister Blessing.
But we have such a big church. And
you want me to go and dip my hand into the church account? You know, I'm a Christian.
Let me help you now. After all, I'm a member of the ushering team. So I know that at least every Sunday when we take offering, we take tithes and people do Thanksgiving, you can put it together, 3,000 euros. Otherwise, I will send this first to your wife, then to the council of elders in the church, and then you know we are in the era of social media. It will just be all over that the anointed holy man of God, see the
sister, bless me,
beautiful art of pastor. Sister, do you know how the caption will go? Please. It will go like,
please.
Randy Pastor or Pastor with Ed
Usher. I'm sorry, please, just forget.
Come on, holiness pastor, please. Stand up
please.
Now.
Please.
Stand up, pastor. See, I don't have any problem. On, you know, the only thing that can give me problem is if you refuse to give me 3,000. And I'm giving you 1 week, just 1 week, to get the 3,000 euros across to me. Otherwise, I will send the video first to your wife, and then to the council of elders. And next, I'm going to send it online, everybody is going to see it. The powerful anointed Pastor Paul, holiness preacher. You see. The holiness preacher, we are going to put it on here and everybody is going to see it. Holiness pastor. So pastor, wait. I'm going to forward my account number to you. Okay, pastor? Put it there. Otherwise, you know what I'm capable of doing. Okay. Yeah. Yes! I'm in money now. Yeah, mission accomplished. Pastor. Alright, pastor, I'm going to be waiting for my money. Otherwise, I'm going to put it on social media. First and foremost, your wife. Pastor. Serious pastor.
Lord, forgive me, Lord Jesus. I'm sorry. Forgive me, Lord. What did I do? Lord, I'm sorry. Father, forgive me my sins. Forgive me my sins, Lord. If you forget our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Lord Jesus, forgive me my sins. I'm sorry. Forgive me, Lord Jesus. Forgive me, Lord Jesus. Jesus, oh Lord, I'm sorry. Lord, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Lord, sister, bless him. Sister, bless him. My God. What do I do now? Holy Spirit, teach me what I should do. Do I need to conceal everything from my wife? Or should I reveal everything to my wife? My reputation. My stand. How will I explain to my wife? How about my children, Lord, have mercy upon me. Sister, bless. I was not watchful enough. Holy Spirit, teach me what to do. I'm sorry. Lord. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Lord Jesus. Lord, have mercy, Lord. I know what to do.
Well, today is the D-Day. Hello, Pastor. Hello. Yes, now. I'm here already. Hello. When you said I should meet you. Okay. Yeah, the restaurant in the central. Yes, I'm waiting for you here. Can you please make it snappy? I have other things to do, okay? All right. Okay, see you soon. I'm going to order for... I'm going to order for all the new designer's shoe and bag. And then I'm going to send money home for them to put one or two things in place for me. Then I will go for a long holiday. Yeah! Money has come! 3,000. Let's start with that. That's not the end. Ah, Pastor! Hi, Pastor!
Leave me alone!
Uh-uh. Anyway, no problem. Well, Pastor, you asked me to meet you here.
Yes.
In the open where we can talk.
Yes.
As my house now become, you know, like a lion's den. Anyway, Pastor, where's my money?
Which money?
The money now? For what you did?
You are not going to get a single dime.
Pastor, lower your voice. You're shouting. Everybody's going to be hearing what we say. You don't go in the...
I don't care.
You don't care.
For your record.
You don't care. You don't care about your reputation before your wife. You don't care about your reputation before the church committee. You don't care about your reputation before the whole world. You see?
Wait.
And Pastor, try to lower your voice.
I've confessed to God. Mm-hmm. And God has forgiven me. Mm-hmm. I've confessed to my wife. My wife has forgiven me.
What did you mean?
I have even gone to the Council of Elders. Jeez. And I've told them I confess and they've forgiven me.
Pastor!
So
did I hear you say you talked to your wife? Did I hear you say you confessed to your wife?
God has forgiven me.
Oh,
and you're not going to get any damn. If you like, go and publish the video all over the social media. I don't care. Huh. I am free. I'm free indeed. So Pastor? What else do you want?
No. It is a lie. You didn't tell your wife. I'm going to send the video to your wife right away. You are daring me, Pastor. You don't know what I'm capable of doing.
Do your worst. I don't care. My wife is behind me. The Council of Elders are behind. And God Almighty is behind. And let me tell you one thing. You better stop this blackmailing. Repent of your ways.
Hello, Mommy Pastor. okay. Sister Blessing on the line. I'm fine. Well, I just want you to know that your husband has a little secret with me. What? He already told you?
Have you heard now? I've confessed my sins to God and all of God has forgiven me. So, if you like, continue in this blackmailing. God is going to punish you, but I'm warning you, you better desist from doing this kind of evils. Nonsense. Bye.
And I thought I've gotten this man. So what is my game now? Yeah. He has told his wife. And the wife is even telling me that he has told the councils of elders. Cha-cha-cha-cha. That means everybody in the church will have known about it. Blessing, you are in trouble. Then, it is now, everybody has already known. But how could? Where did he get the boldness to go and confess? Where did he get it from? I was thinking because he's an holiness preacher, because he does not have like any stain on him, that I've gotten him in my grip. Blessing, you are finished. Blessing, you are finished. I have to leave this town. I can't go to that same church again. I have to leave town immediately. Immediately, sir. I have to leave town.
Praise the Lord. We thank God for this wonderful drama ministration, and I believe the Lord has ministered to you. You have gained one thing or two from this drama, and I pray all the lessons you have learned from this drama shall be permanent in the name of Jesus. Let's look at the word of God, 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. The book of 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. The Bible says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. We can see from the life of the pastor and Sister Blessing, the pastor was not watchful enough, but Sister Blessing was after him. And here the Bible is saying, be sober, as Christians, as believers. The Bible is encouraging us, be sober, be vigilant, always. Why? Because your adversary, the devil, he can use any man, he can use any woman, he can use anybody just to lead you into sin, to lead you into destruction. And I pray the Lord will deliver us in Jesus' name. The Bible says the devil is walking about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. He will not devour you, he will not devour me in the name of Jesus. I pray God will help us. The pastor was not watchful enough. And look at what happened. He was led into sin. And the devil wants to shut his mouth up. He didn't want him to, because if you notice something, if you confront sin and you refuse to confess, you will be going deeper and deeper into destruction. And the Lord is saying, whosoever shall confess and forsake his sin shall obtain mercy. Let's look at the book of 1 John chapter 2. 1 John chapter 2, verse 1. 1 John chapter 2, verse 1. 1 John chapter 2, verse 1. The Bible says, 1 John chapter 2, verse 1. My little children, these things write I unto you, that ye sin not. That is the first injunction. You do not sin. But, and if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. Verse 2. And he is the propitiation for our sin, and not for our sins only, for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. So Jesus is our advocate. Have you fallen into sin? Has the devil shut up your mouth? Then I'm encouraging you, confess your sin to God. As a pastor, you have been molesting the young girls in your church, and then you just confess and say, oh, I don't want to confess my sin to anybody. Confess your sin to God and confess your wife to your to the appropriate quarters. I pray God will give you the courage. Because if you don't confess, the devil will continue to lead you into destruction day by day. I pray God will deliver you in the name of Jesus. As a man, you have committed adultery and you are keeping it away from your wife. What have you done about it? God is calling you, come and repent of your sin. Come to Jesus. He will transform your life. As a woman, have you gone into sin of adultery and you are keeping it away from your husband? God is warning you. He's calling you, come back home. And as a young brother or sister, you are in courtship and you have been committing sin, sleeping together. And then you say, let's cover it up. Let's cover it up. A day is coming when you will not have chance to repent again, and then you'll be languishing in hellfire. Confess your sin. Stop that act. God will give you the grace in the name of Jesus. And perhaps you are there, you are the one blackmailing all these men of God, or any man, or any woman. You are blackmailing, just collecting money, and you are threatening to post that video on the social media. You better repent. If you continue in that sin, the judgment of God is coming. And I pray God will help you in the name of Jesus. By the grace of God, you have watched this drama. The Lord is telling us we should be watchful against the wiles of the devil. We are in the end time. And the devil is using every tactic just to pull down the children of God. You will not fall. You will not be a victim. Rather, you will continue to triumph day by day in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. The grace of God is available to keep you, to keep me from falling. And we will not fall in the name of Jesus. Once again, you have watched this video. The Lord will interpret it into your heart in the name of Jesus. Thank you and God bless you. Until then, have a nice week. Bye.